Okay. I would like to present you the talk about investigation of Langer processes in condensed matter on Helles setup, overview and prospects. This work was done in collaboration with Frumkin Institute of Physical Chemistry and Electrochemistry of Russian Academy of Sciences. The Helles facility operates with continuous ion beams with current up to 40 milliamperes and energies up to 50 kV. This multipurpose accelerator addresses to the wide spectrum of physics experiment. Nowadays, at Helles, we are investigating the interaction of deuterium beam with deuterium-enriched targets. This talk presents the results of studies of the direction in crystalline structures using ion accelerator Helles. Helles facility represents an accelerator of different gases to energy less than 50 kV and include ion source with equipment providing his power supply, beam focusing system, vacuum system, diagnostic apparatus for measuring current and ion beam energy. This is a block diagram of Helles installation. It's a measurement of cross-section of nuclear fusion reaction at low energies is of considerable interest, both for creating new generation power plants and for understanding the processes taking place inside stars. Next slides show some previous works on the study of deuterium at low energies. First work of lunar collaboration is very well known and frequently referred. The electron screening effect in deuterium has been studied for many deuterated metals and insulators, and they observed high screening of deuterium and enhancement of deuterium in some metal targets in comparison with gaseous targets. An explanation of this apparently novel feature of the periodic table is missing. Kasagi and his colleagues investigated anomalously enhanced deuterium in palladium and palladium oxide, observed at very low bombarding energies. They also observed enhancement of deuterium extremely higher than in gaseous targets. Nowadays, now experimental tasks were following. The study of yields of deuterium with protons and neutrons in deuterated structures is the same experiment. Measuring the emission of protons and neutrons and their comparison using variety of techniques. Measurement of deuterium yield in screening potentials for materials in the energy range less than 25 kV, and study of anisotropy of deuterium yields in various materials. Also investigation of heat release in deuterated targets when they are irradiated with ion beams. Nowadays at Helles we study nuclear reactions in the interactions of deuterium beam with deuterium-enriched targets. In these experiments, we used polycrystalline deuterium-enriched targets like titanium, palladium, and CVD diamond. Here you can see how we placed our detectors around the interaction point. This is a helium-3-based detector, and this is SAR-39 detectors surrounding interaction point. Seek target deuterium yield calculated with using this well-known formula. Enhancement factor is determined as a ratio of the direction yield measured in the experiment to the calculated yield. Screening potential is a parameter which characterized the enhancement factor. Palladium-palladium oxide samples have been prepared by following procedure and electrolytically loaded with deuterium directly before irradiation. On the surface of palladium-palladium oxide, we observed numerous pores after irradiation. Saturation of the titanium sample have been carried out long before irradiation because the titanium deuterate compound is absolutely stable at 300 Kelvin. On the surface of titanium deuterate, sometimes we observed craters and never observed pores. Here you can see the structure of polycrystalline diamond in cross section. Polycrystalline diamond film look like columns growing from 1 microns to the 100 microns. This is the growth site of the sample. The gaps between columns filled deuterium atoms after electrolytic saturation. Next slide shows the dependence of the direction yield from the titanium deuterated targets on the deuterium beam energy. The measured direction yield along the beam compared with the yield calculated for given energy and enhancement factor at 10 kNeV, as you see, is equal of 2. Next slide shows the dependence of the direction yield from palladium deuterated targets compared with calculated yield, and the enhancement factor at 10 kVV was equal of 4. The screening potentials were calculated for two extreme conditions. The first one at the metal melting temperature on the, in the beam region, and second at the temperature equal to 350 Kelvin as a temperature measured by thermocouple thermometer at the target edge. Comparison with calculations show significant effects of the direction yield enhancement. The screening potential strongly depends not only target materials, but also on the experimental conditions, target temperature and beam current density. We studied also the possibility of stimulating the direction yield from titanium palladium structures by ion beams using LCTAP. Instead of deuteron beam, we used hydrogen or neon ion beams to irradiate titanium and palladium deuterated targets. Comparison of reading front and back side of SER-39 detectors placed over the targets indicates the presence of proton emission from the direction. This reading from front side, this green is reading from back side. You can see the presence of some charged particles on the surface. Next slide show Helle's experimental data of neutron emission on stimulation of the direction yield in deuterated titanium targets by hydrogen and neon beam. You also can see that average background was measured average background was measured using Cooper target without deuterium, and if we used deuterated target, we observed neutron emission stimulated by ion beams. The situation with stimulation is similar in the case of stimulating deuterated palladium target by neon ion beam. Also, if you used deuterated target, sometimes we exceed the level of 3 sigma of average background. In our previous investigations of the direction in crystal targets, an anisotropy was observed. Neutron flux along the beam direction was higher than that in the transverse direction. This effect could be explained by presence of narrow channels in the samples, where the bulk of deuterium trapped during the electrolysis is concentrated. Particularly large anisotropy was observed using polycrystalline textured CVD diamond samples. Next slide shows the scheme of the experiment to measure the dependence of the direction yield from the increased angle of beam, from the incidence angle of the beam on the target. The neutron yield obtained with CVD diamond sample as a function of angle beta between the beam and the target plane norm showed strong anisotropy. It was higher than factor of 3 at beta equal to 0 compared to that at beta plus minus 42 degrees. If we use as a target compound NC20, such compound also have 80% of diamond and 20% of graphite. This material have absolutely isotropic structures, and it was observed that the neutron yield from the isotropic sample practically independent on the sample orientation with respect to the beam. Next slide shows the dependence of the neutron yield from palladium. Deuterated palladium sample and titanium deuterated samples on the angle beta. As we shown, palladium samples also demonstrate some strong dependence on angle beta. And we showed that palladium sample have many pores after radiation, which resulted in anisotropy in neutron yield. Possible reasons for increasing of the direction yield are following. Screening effects of deuterium nuclei in crystal structure, collective processes associated with high concentration of deuterium in certain directions, the effect of channeling, leading to increase of ineffective range of ions in a direction of the channel. Next slides show X-ray, neutron, and charged particle emission under X-ray radiation of deuterated structures. This is a scheme of location of detectors surrounding interaction point. We used both X-ray tube with lens and with collimator to stimulate the direction in some samples. When irradiated deuterated crystal structures with X-ray quanta products of nuclear reactions are observed as neutrons and charged particles. Measurement by different methods, analysis of X-ray spectra of fluorescence reveals additional peaks which appeared when we irradiate CVD diamond and palladium targets. Analysis of the spectra shows that this peak, appearance of this peak cannot be connected with any known element as well as with diffraction processes. This is a spectrum for palladium deuterated targets. We also observe some new peaks. And when we rotate target X-ray tube and detector, we observe the position of these states not shift, we can show that this is not connected with diffraction processes. The position of this peak are different for deuterated CVD diamond and palladium deuterated target. Now there is no some hypothesis what is this PK, maybe new type of X-ray emission from excited crystal with special structure. And for homogeneous structure like titanium or like carbon, we not observed additional peaks. When irradiated deuterated crystal structures with X-ray, products on mutual reactions are observed as neutrons and charged particles. Measurement by different methods indicates neutron emission with an average intensity up to 10 in the seconds power. And sometimes the neutron flux reaches the value up to 10 in fourth power. Measurement of the CR39 and silicon sulfur barrier detector indicate the emission of charged particle with an average intensity near 10 per second into 4 p steradian. This is a summary of different experiments with different targets. We also observed on the spectrum with CCB detector the emission of particles with energies more than 10 MeV. And this gives an indication on the possibility of stimulating multi-particle fusion reactions of deuterated nuclei in solid deuterated structures. In this case, we investigate zirconium deuterated targets. The same spectrum was obtained with titanium deuterated target. We also observed some alpha particles with energies more than 10 MeV. Next slide show investigation of heat release from the target. We measure the temperature at the edge of target using thermocouple thermometer and cooling the substrate of target. It is shown that when deuterium ion beams act to titanium deuterate target, the heat release is it much higher than the heat release in the same target with hydrogen and neon beam radiation. You can observe that heat release much higher in the case of deuterium beam with a high current density. This effect. At the same time, the yield of neutrons from the direction didn't exceed the value 10 and fifth power neutrons per second per in 4 p steradian. Possible explanation for excess heat is the reaction of DD fusion with production of helium-4 atom and heating of crystal. Perhaps in crystal lattice, classic reaction at low energies is strongly suppressed, and reaction with production of helium is basic. (Clears throat) Our conclusions. The results of measurements of deterioration yield from palladium and titanium structures show a significant effect of deterioration yield enhancement. It was first shown that the impact of hydrogen and neon ion beams on the deteriorated structures result in appreciable deterioration yield stimulation. It is observed that the crystalline structure in the orientation of sample with respect to the plane of ion beam has an impact on the neutral yield. The highest yield is recorded with CVD diamond target oriented perpendicular to the beam. When radiated deteriorated crystal structures with X-ray quanta products of nuclear reactions are observed at neutron discharged particles. Measurement of by different methods indicate neutron emission with an average energy up to 10 in second power per second. Measurement of CR39 and CCB detector indicates the emission of charged particles with an energy intensity, with average intensity near 10 per second to 4 pistereda. Emission of particles with energy more than 10 keV gives an indication of possibility of stimulating multi-particle fusion reaction of deuterium nuclei in solid deuterated structures. Analysis of spectra of X-ray fluorescence reveals additional peaks that are not identified as any characteristic radiation lines. The appearance cannot be connected with any known element as well as with diffraction processes. It is shown that when deuterium ion beams act on titanium deuterated targets, the heat release is much more higher than the heat release in the same target with hydrogen and neon beam of the same power is exposed. Well, the neutron yield of the neutron deterioration doesn't exceed 10^5 neutrons per second to pisteradian. Our further plan to continue the study, the enhancement of deterioration in various materials in order to obtain materials with high screening potential, continue to study the stimulation of deterioration by various methods in order to obtain optimal mechanism to controlling the linear processes. Also, we plan to study the heat release in various crystalline structures when exposed to the beams of ions and electrons in order to obtain maximum energy release with minimum energy consumption. We also plan to study promising neutron-free nuclear fusion reaction, boron plus hydrogen, deuterium plus helium-3, helium-3 plus helium-3, and others in crystalline structures in order to obtain the safe heat power for future power plants. Thank you for attention. This is a list of our publication. Thank you.
Last year, there was a workshop in Grecio, and someone mentioned graphite as having a very large screening potential. Graphite.
Graphite?
Yes.
Pure graphite.
Pure graphite.
Pure graphite. We don't investigate directly pure graphite as a question of increasing of neutron yield. We also investigate the dependence, the neutron yield of orientation of target in the in my opinion, pure graphite have not such high screening potential.
Well, I would like to follow up on that comment. So in my presentation, I was referring to Lipoglavcek study, where they studied proton deuterium fusion in the accelerator environment, and they also used graphite. So they observed these Zitterbewegung orbit electrons in the pure graphite environment. Mm-hmm. So I think it is interesting to study, at least the Lipoglavcek group had very interesting results with pure graphite.
I think it's possible to continue to investigate pure graphite using helium. It's useful.
Okay. Well, two questions. Yeah.
Ah, 그쪽이.
For the beam experiment, it is very important to know the real number of the target, which yeah, you are impinging a deuterium always. Yes. So therefore, the target number of the target target deuterons may change. So how do you control that? That's one question. And the other one is, okay.
Yes. The concentration of deuterium inside the target before experiment, of course, we try to control using difference mass before saturation and after saturation, and some other chemical special methods to control. And we also control the target after radiation, and we try to apply some other methods to obtain a real concentration of the boundary layer radiated by beam.
Okay. The other one is to get the good screen potential.
Yes.
You need. You need the. The experiment with less incident energies. So your case is the lowest energy is 10 keV. Yes. So it seems to me it's still very high. So you have to go down. Then my question is, how about the minimum energy you can use such kind of a...
Yes. I think to reach less energy with high current, we need to stop accelerated deuterons, accelerated, for example, up to 15 keV to 5 keV. We need to apply additional equipment for heli setup and measure deuterational yield with high current density.
So probably you're aware that the Chersky group had to go to very low vacuum to prevent oxide formation on the surface to get a good screening number. So that's a comment. In addition, I'm interested in what your beam energy was for your titanium heat result, and I'm interested in your target structure. What do you mean by a titanium deuteride oxide target?
On my opinion, that screening potential is very strong dependence of heating or cooling the target. Chersky group cool the target using liquid nitrogen. Yes, I think yes.
But, well, I was referring to the vacuum. So they're below 10 to the minus 10th torr or some... ridiculous.
Helis operates in vacuum 10^-6.
I think it's very much better than 10^-6 torr.
Our result shows that screening potential strongly depends on condition of experiment. And if you apply current density more and more, you obtain screening potential more and more. The collective processes begin to influence the neutron yield.